Early morning flights, but that's just a short flight, like 500 kilometers. You could drive that like in six or 7 hours in a car. That takes a long time. If you live in Memphis, you will drive like 5 a.m. in the morning. You have to drive to the airport, and then when you arrive in Atlanta, you need to take a taxi away from the airport. So actually, you're not saving so much time if you drive like 4 a.m. in the morning from Memphis. You could be like in Atlanta 6 a.m. in the morning on 6 hours. So you're not saving so much time to fly this short distance, because you need to spend a lot of time to get to the airport, parking your car, get into the airport and boarding and security. Then you have to get away from next airport and renting a car or take a taxi and walk like half an hour from the gate to taxi. So you're not saving so much time. But of course, you could fly 6 a.m. in the morning from Memphis. If you have a meeting like 9 a.m. or 8:30, you can actually do that. If you have a business meeting 8:30 a.m. in the morning, you can fly from Memphis to Atlanta and be there around 7 a.m. in the morning. It's like 7:15. Like before 7:30, then you have 1 hour to 8:30. So actually you can do that, but you cannot do that in a car. Then you have to drive like 2 a.m. in the night if you have a meeting at 8:30 in Atlanta. You will need to drive in 2 a.m. in the night. Or you could drive at 4, 6 p.m. and then drive 6 hours to, and then sleep on a hotel. You will be in Atlanta like midnight, 12 midnight, and then sleep in a hotel to 7 a.m. in the morning. This is a real flight. Somebody that's sitting more than 100 people. I don't know what aircraft is it. It's a Boeing 737. Could have like 150 passengers, maybe. More than 100 people are sitting into here. And if I was CIA or FBI, I could actually see properly, I could see who is sitting inside. If I was a government intelligence, I could log in and see who is actually sitting into there. I could track all the people. But I am not, I'm old YouTuber from Denmark, so I cannot do that. So now the sun get up, but that's just a short flight. That's the most busy flight, Memphis, Atlanta. No, we can see the local time on the flights. Yes, I hope we can see, because this screen back on my camcorder is not showing what I actually see on the screen. What time is it? No, it only says 11 minutes ago. Actually time then I can add is about 6:15 a.m. and we got 14 minutes, so actually it takes much longer time. Oh, I think that's different time zones. That does not take 2 hours and 80 minutes. I think it takes 1 hour and 80. Sorry, I'm burping because I'm drinking so much cola. No, it takes like 1 hour 20 minutes, not 2 hours. Of course they're crossing a time zone, I think, so they got like half an hour left. That's a 6 years old aircraft, and you got the registration and serial numbers, and 27 still climbing, 28,000 feet. But that's only like 400 kilometers, so they're going like when there's like 200 kilometers left, it descending. And ground speed is 470 knots. So I will, but I can see the time there. It's 6:22. I think it's 6:22 there, but they're crossing a time zone, so it's 7:22 soon. So now we are 29,000 feet, close to 30,000 feet. I'm back. Yes, I don't know what river, but we could just click there. That's Pickwick Lake. Okay, now I did click away by mistake. But that's not so many aircraft. Let's try to find it. I think that's the one there. I don't know what city that is. That's, of course, I'm laying in my bed. So Yes, I cannot read it because I'm laying in my bed and my eyes are tired. We are in Alabama. We have crossed Alabama. But we can do it in this one. No, we can. I forgot that. We could click like here. That's Muscle Shoals, Northwest Alabama. So we have a kind of city down here. We are in Alabama State. But Georgia, that's not Georgia. Atlanta is not in Alabama, that's in Georgia State. So we have like 350 kilometers left. But we have some rivers there, but they call the rivers lake. They don't have a river name, they call it lake name. But this is not a lake, this is a long wide river with a lake name. And I just look this view because I just do this to relax and fun. And I've not done it like 1 year because I had a long break using a flight radar and actually I forgot to unsubscribe my gold subscription, so I have been paying like more than half a year, $5 every month, but I did not see that until a few days ago. Then I did cancel my subscription a few days ago. Then I have signed up again last night because actually I like to have this, so that's just $5 every month. Course I can use it like this one. I can use it on my video. So now we are 33,000 feet. That's 10 kilometers, 10,000 meters. But we use always use feet in aviation. So now we are cruising a little bit. Then we are descending very soon, like 10 minutes. We are descending. So if you was flying like a turboprop, like the De Havilland Dash 8, you could not fly like this. You could not get up to like 33,000 feet and then fly this fast. You could get up to like, I don't know how high they're getting, like 15,000 feet or 20. I don't think they go because they don't have a pressure cabin. I think they go to like 10,000 feet or 15. They don't have a pressure cabin, air pressure cabin in the De Havilland Dash 8 400, I think. I'm not sure. I don't think they have an air pressure cabin in the Dash 8 400. But there was no cargo flight from Memphis this morning. So probably they fly in the evening.